Welcome, time travelers and Star Trek enthusiasts. Today, we're embarking on an extraordinary journey through the cosmos to explore the life and legacy of one of the most fascinating characters in the Star Trek universe, Data. This remarkable Soong-type android has captivated audiences for decades. Standing as a testament to the boundless possibilities of artificial intelligence, and the exploration of what it means to be truly human. So, buckle up as we delve into the world of Data, exploring his origins, his journey in Starfleet, and the profound impact he has had on both the Star Trek lore and our understanding of humanity itself. And before we launch into this adventure, remember to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated on all our interstellar content. Please note, there will be spoilers ahead for Star Trek Picard Season 3.
Indeed, his story isn't just about technology. It's about the quest for identity and purpose, something that resonates with all of us, organic or synthetic.
Precisely. Data's existence challenges our preconceptions and pushes the boundaries of our understanding. His journey from a mere assemblage of circuits and positronic pathways to a beloved and integral member of the Starfleet community is nothing short of inspiring. Now, let's set our coordinates and begin our exploration into the life of this extraordinary android. Let's start at the very beginning, the creation of Data. Our story unfolds with the brilliant yet enigmatic cyberneticist, Dr. Noonien Soong. Nestled in his secluded laboratory on the distant colony of Omicron Theta, Dr. Soong embarked on a groundbreaking journey, one that would ultimately redefine the limits of artificial life. His ambition: to create an android indistinguishable from humans in intellect and emotion.
It wasn't an easy path for Dr. Soong. He faced numerous setbacks. Before Data, there were others, early prototypes that didn't quite hit the mark. Each failure, however, brought invaluable lessons, paving the way for his ultimate success.
Indeed, and then came Data, a technological marvel imbued with a positronic brain of unparalleled complexity. Data represented the culmination of Dr. Soong's life's work, a synthesis of advanced robotics and artificial intelligence. Crafted not just to mimic human appearance, but to possess the potential for growth, learning, and perhaps even understanding emotions.
Huh! Imagine the Ferengi trying to sell such a thing. Buy your own android, almost human, slightly used.
Well, Igorks, it's a bit more profound than a sales pitch. Data's existence marked a new era in synthetic life, a beacon of possibility in the vast sea of stars. Dr. Soong's dream wasn't just to create an android. It was to bridge the gap between machine and humanity.
A noble goal, but fraught with challenges. It's one thing to craft an android that can calculate faster than a supercomputer, quite another to create one that can understand the nuances of a Shakespearean sonnet or the beauty of a sunset.
Exactly. And so, Data's journey began, not just as a feat of engineering, but as a quest to understand the very essence of what it means to be alive. As we explore Data's origins, we must delve into the intriguing dynamic of his family. First, there's Lore, Data's older brother, also a creation of Dr. Soong. Crafted with emotions, Lore's existence raised profound ethical questions. His emotional programming was, in a way, too successful, imbuing him with traits like jealousy and ambition. Lore's emotions weren't tempered with the ethical and moral grounding necessary for such a powerful being.
His superiority complex and manipulative nature eventually led to his deactivation. It was a tough decision, highlighting the delicate balance in creating sentient beings.
Indeed. Then we have Before, an earlier prototype, less sophisticated than Data and Lore. Before's simplicity led him to being unstable and often catatonic.
Sounds like B forgot the short end of the stick in the brains department. Why create such an android in the first place?
It's a valid question, Igorx. B4 illustrates the evolutionary path of Dr. Soong's work. Each android, from B4 to Lore to Data, shows a progression in complexity and capability.
And let's not forget Juliana Tainer, another fascinating figure in Data's life. She was an android replica of Dr. Soong's wife and, in essence, Data's mother. Her creation brings us to the heart of a moral quandary, the ethics of replicating a human consciousness in an android body.
Juliana's story adds yet another layer to the ethical tapestry of artificial life. Was it right for Soong to create her without her knowledge of being an android? The implications of such actions are profound, touching on themes of identity, consent, and the nature of existence itself. Data's early life at the Omicron Theta colony is entwined with a pivotal and tragic event involving his brother, Lore. Lore's complex character played a crucial role in the colony's fate. His interaction with the crystalline entity, a space-faring life form, led to a catastrophic outcome.
It's chilling to think about. Lore, driven by a sense of superiority and resentment towards humans, betrayed his own colony. He communicated with the crystalline entity, inviting it to Omicron Theta, leading to the destruction of all life on the planet. It's a stark reminder of the risks involved in creating sentient beings with unchecked emotions.
Indeed, the consequences of Lore's actions were profound and far-reaching. The attack wiped out the colony, leaving Data deactivated and abandoned among the ruins. It wasn't until a Starfleet team discovered him years later that he was reactivated and began a new chapter in his life.
Talk about family drama. But hey, at least we got Data out of it. Imagine the Enterprise without him. I've seen some impressive gadgets in my time, but Data takes the prize. Who wouldn't want a crew member who doesn't sleep and can calculate faster than a Ferengi counting latinum?
Indeed, Igorx. Data's physical and mental capabilities were not just for show. They played a crucial role in his integration into Starfleet and his journey therein. Let's delve into the essence of what makes Data truly extraordinary. His physical design is a marvel of engineering, a seamless integration of form and function. But the real masterpiece lies within his positronic brain.
That's right, Time Lord. The positronic brain is the cornerstone of Data's existence. It's a complex network of synthetic neurons, enabling him to process information and experience the world in a way that's akin to human cognition, yet far surpasses it in speed and efficiency.
This brain allows Data not just to think and learn, but to evolve over time. It's designed to mimic human neural patterns, yet it's capable of feats well beyond our own capabilities.
Sounds like the perfect crew member. No sleep, no food, just give him a good puzzle, and he's all set.
Precisely, but Data's physical capabilities don't stop there. His strength, agility, and sensory perceptions are all enhanced, giving him abilities that are indispensable to the varied and often perilous missions of Starfleet.
Indeed, his strength is about 10 times that of a human, and his sensory inputs provide a range of data that we can only dream of. From infrared vision to analyzing chemical compositions by taste, Data's capabilities are a testament to Dr. Soong's genius.
It's this unique blend of physical prowess and intellectual capacity that made Data an invaluable member of the Starfleet crew, impacting countless missions and lives. In the year 2338, the USS Tripoli, exploring the far reaches of the galaxy, made a landmark discovery on Omicron Theta. Amidst the remnants of a devastated colony, they found an inactive android, Data.
Data's integration into Starfleet was a unique journey. Initially viewed with curiosity and skepticism, he quickly proved his worth. His initial years were filled with assignments that tested and honed his abilities, laying the foundation for his illustrious career.
Before he became a key member of the USS Enterprise D crew, Data served in various capacities within Starfleet. His remarkable computational abilities, coupled with an unquenchable thirst for knowledge, made him an asset in every role he undertook. Data's journey took a pivotal turn when he was assigned to the USS Enterprise D under the command of Captain Jean-Luc Picard. Serving as the operations officer, Data became an integral part of the crew, involved in some of the most critical missions of the Federation.
Data's tenure on the Enterprise D saw him involved in a myriad of notable incidents. From encounters with the Borg Collective to the mysteries of the Q Continuum, Data consistently demonstrated his exceptional abilities and his growing understanding of human behavior.
It wasn't just his operational efficiency that stood out. Data's interactions with the crew were equally significant. His unique perspective often provided invaluable insights. And his journey towards understanding humanity endeared him to his colleagues and viewers alike.
Yes, and who can forget his ongoing chess games with Troy, or his violin performances in Ten Forward? Data's quest to understand and experience music, art, and humor brought a relatable, almost childlike charm to his character.
His relationships with fellow crew members, especially his close bond with Geordi LaForge, added depth to his character, portraying him not just as an android, but as a valued friend and confidant. Data's sentience was brought into contest in a pivotal trial episode. The trial depicted in the episode, The Measure of a Man, was convened to decide whether Data should be considered Starfleet property or a sentient individual with rights. The issue arose when Commander Bruce Maddox, a Starfleet cyberneticist, sought to dismantle Data for research, believing him to be no more than a sophisticated machine.
The trial saw Captain Picard defending Data's autonomy, arguing passionately that Data met the criteria of self-awareness, consciousness, and intelligence, and thus deserved the same rights as any other member of the Federation. It was a powerful display of advocacy, emphasizing the themes of individuality and self-determination.
On the other side, Commander William Riker, albeit reluctantly, presented a compelling case for the opposition, demonstrating Data's mechanical nature and the potential benefits of replicating him for Starfleet's use. Riker's demonstration, where he switched Data off, was a chilling reminder of Data's unique nature.
Ultimately, Judge Philippe Alouvois ruled in favor of Data, recognizing him as a sentient being with the right to make his own decisions. This landmark decision was not just a victory for Data, but a significant moment in Federation law, acknowledging the rights of artificial life forms.
Data's trial was a profound exploration of what defines life and sentience. It challenged viewers to consider the ethical and moral implications of artificial intelligence and set a precedent for the treatment of sentient beings, regardless of their origin. Data's first encounter with his brother Lore is a significant chapter in his story, one that delves deep into the complexities of their shared origin and contrasting personalities. The initial meeting, as seen in the episode Data Lore, occurs when the crew of the USS Enterprise D visits Data's home planet, Omicron Theta. There, they discover Lore, another android created by Dr. Noonien Soong, who is strikingly similar to Data, but with some key differences. During the episode, Data and the Enterprise crew reassemble Lore. Initially, Lore seems to bond with Data, sharing insights into their creation and existence. However, it soon becomes apparent that Lore's intentions are far from benign. His superiority complex and resentment towards humans quickly surface, revealing a manipulative and dangerous nature. Lore's deception and eventual betrayal of Data and the Enterprise crew mark a pivotal moment for Data. It forces him to confront not only the darker potential of artificial intelligence, but also the complexities of his own identity. The encounter with Lore serves as a harsh lesson in trust and the moral ambiguities of sentient existence.
This confrontation also highlights the stark contrast between Data and Lore. Where Data embodies curiosity and a desire to assimilate into human culture, Lore represents the potential perils of unchecked emotions and superiority in artificial beings.
The episode concludes with Data taking the difficult but necessary action of stopping Lore, showcasing his commitment to Starfleet principles and the safety of his crew. It's a defining moment that solidifies Data's place as a trusted and valued member of the Enterprise, despite the challenges posed by his complex nature as an android. Now, let's delve into one of the most emotionally charged chapters of Data's journey, his reunion with his creator, Dr. Noonien Soong, and the unexpected return of Lore. This encounter unveils layers of Data's origins and his quest for emotions, marking a turning point in his life. Dr. Soong, believing he is on the brink of death, summons Data to his laboratory on Terlina 3. The intent is to bestow upon Data his latest invention, the emotion chip, a device designed to grant Data the ability to experience human emotions.
The technology behind the emotion chip is indeed revolutionary, integrating seamlessly with Data's positronic brain. It holds the promise of completing Data's quest for understanding human feelings, a quest that has defined much of his existence.
However, the reunion takes an unexpected turn. Lore intercepts the message and arrives instead, seeking the emotion chip for himself. In a twist of fate, Dr. Soong accidentally implants the chip into Lore, mistaking him for Data. Lore's reaction to the emotion chip is vastly different from what Dr. Soong intended for Data. Instead of empathy and understanding, Lore becomes more erratic and malevolent, his darker impulses amplified by the chip's integration. In a tragic turn of events, Dr. Soong, realizing his mistake, meets his demise at the hands of Lore. This loss is profound for Data, who had only just begun to reconnect with his father. The encounter leaves Data grappling with complex emotions of loss and betrayal, emotions he can understand but not fully experience. The episode is a poignant reminder of the fine line between creation and destruction in the realm of artificial intelligence. It raises profound questions about the responsibilities and ethical dilemmas faced by creators like Dr. Soong, and the impact of their inventions on beings like Data and Lore. A fascinating aspect of Data's journey in understanding humanity was his exploration of the subconscious realm through dreaming. This journey into the world of dreams marked a significant step in Data's continuous quest to emulate human experiences. In a particularly memorable episode, Data starts to experience dreams, a result of his evolving programming. This unexpected development surprises not only Data, but his colleagues aboard the Enterprise D as well. Dreams, inherently human experiences, were previously thought to be beyond Data's capabilities.
The scientific implications of an android dreaming are profound. It suggests a level of complexity in Data's neural network that closely parallels the human brain, blurring the lines between artificial and organic consciousness.
In one of his dreams, Data envisions a surreal scenario involving Deanna Troi as a cellular peptide cake with mint frosting, a metaphorical representation of his subconscious processing his daily interactions and experiences. These dreams, while initially perplexing to Data, provide him with invaluable insights into the human psyche. They allow him to engage with his emotions and thoughts in a way that was previously inaccessible to him, deepening his understanding of not only human experiences, but also his own existence. This exploration of dreams also raises fascinating questions about the nature of consciousness in artificial beings. It challenges the notion of dreams as solely a human or organic phenomenon and opens up possibilities for a deeper emotional and psychological understanding in AI. One of the most compelling arcs in Data's journey, the two-part story, Descent, begins with the Enterprise D crew encountering the Borg. However, these are not the Borg as we know them. They are acting individually, not as a collective. a change brought about by Data's brother, Lore.
The technological interplay between Data and these individual Borg raises questions about the nature of free will and the dangers of persuasive and charismatic leadership, particularly when Lore manipulates these Borg.
Data is lured into Lore's influence through the promise of emotions. Lore provides Data with an emotion chip, but it's skewed to elicit negative emotions. Data begins to feel anger and pleasure, but these feelings are tainted by Lore's manipulations, leading Data down a dangerous path. The climax of the story is a dramatic confrontation where Data's ethical programming is pitted against the malevolent influence of Lore. Data is forced to confront the moral implications of his actions under the influence of the emotion chip. Ultimately, Data's inherent goodness and his loyalty to his friends and Starfleet prevail. He deactivates Lore and removes the emotion chip, choosing to return to his emotionless state. Recognizing that the pursuit of emotions, if not guided by a moral compass, can lead to disastrous consequences. These episodes are pivotal in Data's evolution. They not only explore the complexities of his character, but also delve into themes of free will, morality, and the perils of unchecked emotions. The narrative takes a significant turn in the film, Star Trek: Generations. Here, Data decides to finally install the emotion chip. This decision marks a new phase in his journey, as he begins to experience the full spectrum of human emotions. The integration of the chip in Generations is not without its challenges. Data experiences the joys of laughter and the thrill of new sensations, but also grapples with fear, anxiety, and even sadness. His journey through these emotions is both humorous and poignant, offering a unique insight into the complexity of the human emotional experience. This period in Data's life is a crucial learning curve. He navigates through his emotions with a sense of curiosity and determination, often relying on his friends for guidance and support. His struggle to balance his emotional responses while maintaining his duties aboard the Enterprise showcases his resilience and adaptability. Data's decision to embrace the emotion chip in Generations symbolizes his continuous quest for understanding and his desire to connect more deeply with the human experience. It's a brave step forward in his journey, reflecting his ongoing exploration of what it truly means to feel and be human. In Star Trek: Nemesis, released in 2002, we witness one of the most significant moments in Data's story. During the climactic battle against the Riemann Warbird Scimitar, Data makes a profound decision that defines his character. Faced with an imminent threat to the USS Enterprise E and its crew, Data chooses to sacrifice himself to save Captain John, Luke Picard, and the ship. He transports Picard back to the Enterprise and then destroys the Scimitar, along with the dangerous Thaleron radiation weapon. By triggering an emergency transport with a handheld device and firing upon the weapon, causing the destruction of the Scimitar and himself in the process. This selfless act is a testament to Data's growth and his deep understanding of the values he's learned from his human counterparts. His sacrifice encapsulates the essence of heroism and selflessness, traits that are quintessentially human. Moving forward to the series Star Trek: Picard, which premiered in 2020, we encounter Data once again, albeit in a different form. Here, he exists as a consciousness within a quantum simulation, a digital afterlife created by his old friend, Bruce Maddox. In this digital realm, Data expresses a desire for a human-like life cycle, including a finite existence. This longing for mortality, to live a life with a beginning and an end, highlights his ongoing exploration of what it means to be human. Data's request to Picard to terminate his consciousness is a poignant moment. It reflects his understanding and acceptance of the human condition, the beauty of a life that is not infinite, but is cherished precisely because it is transient. Data's sacrifice and his later reflections on existence in Picard significantly impact our understanding of his character. It's a powerful demonstration of his journey from an android curious about humanity to a being who embraces the most profound aspects of the human experience, including the inevitability of death. This part of Data's legacy leaves us with much to ponder about life, consciousness, and what it truly means to be human. His story is not just about the evolution of an android, but also a mirror reflecting our own human experiences, challenges, and aspirations. Data's legacy extends beyond his personal journey, profoundly impacting the next generation of synthetic life, particularly the Coppelius androids introduced in Star Trek Picard. Among these new beings are Soji and Dodge, two androids whose creation was directly influenced by Data's legacy. These advanced androids, created on the planet Coppelius by Dr. Alton, Soong, and Bruce Maddox, represent a new frontier in synthetic life. They are imbued with Data's memories and experiences, a testament to his lasting influence in the field of artificial intelligence. Soji and Dodge embody aspects of Data's personality and intellect. They navigate their existence with a similar sense of curiosity and a quest for identity that Data once did. The story of these Coppelius androids, especially in the wake of the synth ban and its eventual lifting, echoes Data's own struggles and triumphs. They face challenges of acceptance and understanding in a universe where the line between synthetic and organic life is increasingly blurred. The saga of Data takes a groundbreaking turn with the creation of the Daystrom android, a remarkable entity that marks a new chapter in the legacy of Soong-type androids. This development in Star Trek, Picard ushers in an innovative iteration of Data, blending his essence with other notable androids. The Daystrom android, constructed by Dr. Alton Soong, is not merely a recreation of Data, but a sophisticated amalgamation of multiple personalities. This android integrates elements from Data, his malevolent brother lore, the simpler before, and other Soong-type androids. It's a bold endeavor to encapsulate the collective experiences and attributes of these distinct beings into a singular, new form. This integration process is more than a technical achievement. It represents a profound exploration of identity and consciousness. The Daystrom android becomes a vessel for the merged memories and traits of its predecessors, creating a unique personality that encompasses the breadth of their collective experiences. The creation of this android raises intriguing questions about the nature of self and the continuity of consciousness. It embodies the hopes, dreams, and even the flaws of those who contributed to its creation, offering a new perspective on what it means to be a Soong-type android. In essence, the Daystrom android is the culmination of Data's journey and the evolution of Soong-type androids. It stands as a testament to the enduring impact of Data's life and the ongoing exploration of synthetic life in the Star Trek universe. Through this new entity, the legacy of Data and his family continues to unfold, promising new adventures and insights in the ever-expanding tapestry of Star Trek lore. In the climactic moments of the merging process within the Daystrom android, a compelling and strategic move by Data unfolded, one that would forever alter the course of both his and Lore's existence. This pivotal event in Star Trek, Picard, is not just a clash of two powerful minds, but a testament to Data's ingenuity and depth of understanding. As Data and Lore struggled for dominance within the confines of the Daystrom android, the situation reached a critical point. Lore, ever the manipulator, sought to overpower and delete Data's personality, aiming to assert complete control over their shared form. However, Data, with his characteristic foresight and understanding of his brother, devised a cunning plan. In a move that showcased his profound comprehension of Lore's psyche, Data offered up his own memories to Lore. These were not mere data points, but the essence of Data's experiences, his interactions with friends aboard the Enterprise D, and even his cherished moments with his cat, Spot. This act was a calculated risk, as it involved handing over the very core of his being to his adversary. Lore, driven by his ego and desire to possess all that made Data unique, greedily absorbed these memories. In doing so, he unwittingly initiated his own undoing. The memories that Data chose to share were imbued with the qualities that defined him. Empathy, kindness, and a quest for understanding. As Lore integrated these memories, he began to experience the effects of his own deletion, a process that ultimately led to the resurgence of Data's personality. This moment was a turning point, where Lore's personality was overwritten by that of Data. In a profound sense, Lore became Data, inheriting not just his memories, but the very essence that made Data who he was. It was a masterstroke by Data, one that used Lore's own ambitions against him and ensured that the best of Data would live on in the Daystrom android. This merging was more than a victory over a nemesis. It was a fusion of two disparate paths into one. The new entity that emerged was a blend of Data's compassion and Lore's complexity, a being that carried forward the legacy of both brothers in a harmonious coexistence. Through this clever maneuver, Data ensured that his values and spirit would continue to shape the future, marking a new chapter in the saga of the Soong type androids.
The creation of the Daystrom android, a new being that embodies the collective experiences and traits of Data, Lore, Before, and other elements, marks a significant chapter in Data's enduring legacy. This development is not just a technological marvel. It's a profound exploration of identity, consciousness, and the essence of what it means to be. The philosophical implications of this development are profound. It raises questions about the nature of self and identity. Can a new consciousness truly emerge from the amalgamation of distinct personalities? What does it mean for an android to inherit human-like qualities and experiences? These questions delve into the heart of what Data's journey has always been about, the exploration of what it means to be alive, to feel, to evolve. It highlights the complex dynamics of artificial intelligence and the responsibilities that come with creating sentient life.
The new entity, shaped by the virtues and flaws of its predecessors, stands as a testament to the potential and risks inherent in the pursuit of advanced AI. As we reflect on Data's journey, from his creation on Omicron Theta to his sacrifice in Nemesis, and now to his legacy living on in the Daystrom android, we see a narrative that is deeply human at its core. Data's story is a canvas upon which the most fundamental questions about life, emotion, and consciousness are painted. This new chapter, with the Daystrom android, continues that exploration, pushing the boundaries of what we understand about artificial and human life alike. Data's legacy, therefore, is one that transcends his physical existence. It's a legacy that continues to inspire, challenge, and provoke thought, not just within the confines of the Star Trek universe, but in our real-world contemplations of artificial intelligence and the nature of our own humanity. As we reflect on the remarkable journey of Data, we can't help but turn our attention to the man who brought this iconic character to life, Brent Spiner. His portrayal of Data in Star Trek, The Next Generation, and subsequent appearances transformed a character of circuits and code into a deeply relatable and beloved figure. Born on February 2, 1949, in Houston, Texas, Brent Spiner found his calling in acting early on. After honing his skills in various stage productions, Spiner's path led him to the iconic role of Data. His casting in Star Trek, The Next Generation, was a pivotal moment, not only in his career, but also in the legacy of the Star Trek franchise. Spiner brought a unique blend of innocence and profound depth to Data, capturing the hearts of audiences worldwide. Spiner's portrayal of Data was a masterclass in balancing the android's quest for humanity with his inherent machine-like nature. He didn't just play Data. He lived the character, infusing him with a soulful presence that transcended the screen. But Spiner's talent didn't stop at Data. He also skillfully portrayed other characters in the Star Trek universe, including Data's malevolent brother Lore and their creator, Dr. Noonien Soong. Each character, though interconnected, was distinctly different, showcasing Spiner's versatility and depth as an actor. Brent Spiner's transformation into Data was a meticulous process that involved extensive makeup and costuming. Every day on set, Spiner underwent a lengthy makeup routine to become the iconic android. This process was crucial in defining Data's unique appearance, characterized by his pale, golden skin and yellow eyes. The makeup not only altered Spiner's appearance, but also played a significant role in helping him embody the character's otherworldly essence. The makeup team, led by Michael Westmore, carefully crafted Data's look to reflect his synthetic nature while maintaining a degree of human-like expressiveness essential for the character. The challenge lay in striking a balance between making Data appear artificial, yet relatable. Spiner's dedication to sitting through these long makeup sessions and his ability to perform expressively under layers of makeup and prosthetics significantly contributed to Data's believability and endearment to fans. The transformation was not just physical. It was a gateway for Spiner to step into Data's world, bringing to life a character that resonated deeply with audiences and became a hallmark of the Star Trek universe. As we reach the end of our journey through the life and legacy of Data, it's clear that his character stands as a monumental figure in the exploration of artificial life within the Star Trek universe. Data's story, beautifully portrayed by Brent Spiner, is not just a tale of an android seeking humanity. It's a mirror reflecting our own quest to understand what it means to be alive, to feel, and to connect with others. His struggles and triumphs, his quest for emotions, and his ultimate sacrifices have left an indelible mark on the hearts of Star Trek fans and on the broader conversation about artificial intelligence. As someone who's had the pleasure of meeting Brent Spiner, I can attest to the warmth and grace he brings to his interactions with fans. His genuine appreciation for the character of Data and the impact it has had on people's lives is evident. It's actors like him who elevate their characters beyond mere scripted entities, infusing them with a life and depth that resonate with audiences across generations. Data, as brought to life by Spiner, is more than a character in a sci-fi series. He's a symbol of the endless possibilities and complexities of existence, whether organic or artificial. In closing, Data's journey through Star Trek is a powerful reminder of the endless potential of storytelling to explore profound themes of identity, humanity, and the nature of consciousness. His story, while set in the realms of futuristic space exploration, touches on universal truths about the human condition and our continual search for meaning and connection. I hope this exploration of Data's life has been as enlightening and enjoyable for you as it has been for me. He's one of my favorite characters, and Spiner's portrayal is a testament to his immense talent and dedication. Thank you for joining me on this journey. If you've enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for notifications on more content like this. Share your thoughts and memories of Data in the comments below, and let's continue to celebrate the rich legacy of Star Trek together. Until next time, this is the Tired Time Lord, signing off. Live long and prosper.